Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cheese pie with summer fruit topping. Now you've probably done cheesecakes a lot, and this is sort of similar in idea, but you don't have to bake it in the oven. It's going to be light and creamy, and it will have some fruits on top that will be a medley of fruits, a mixture of fruits that are in season in the summertime. So you probably can get them, if you're in the United States, you probably can get them at this time of year very easily and at least less expensively than at other times of the year. Now I've decided to put this in a pre-made pie crust. I really don't like those that much, but I've made so many pie crusts in Betty's Kitchen that you have all sorts of things to choose from. You can go to basic pie crust making, you can go to Betty's Best pie crust, or you can do a crumb crust, like you can do graham cracker crust. I even have a chocolate crust, so if you want to stick with this idea of chocolate, then you could use that recipe if you want to. But it's always better if you make your own at home. And also with these, when I take the top off, which I did a few minutes ago, and then you have to turn the edge down, sometimes there will be cracks along the edges, and that's just hard on you when you try to serve the pie because it wants to fall apart. So that's one drawback, but it sure is easy. And also you can pick flavors that might be dark chocolate like this, or you might get the reduced fat variety. You have some options and it's immediately done. Another thing you could do is just buy the refrigerated circles of pie crust that are already made and fit them into a pie dish, and those will be larger than this. This is kind of small and actually will not hold all of my pie, I'm pretty sure. So what I plan to do is to put any leftover pie in these two Pyrex dishes, and then all of those will get refrigerated before the topping goes on, and we'll have a couple little extras there. So it works out pretty well to do it this way. So let's see what we're going to put in our filling. It's a cheese pie, and I'm going to use mascarpone cheese. This is an 8-ounce carton that I've emptied into a large mixing bowl. Now, if you would rather use cream cheese, that will work well. I'll actually put a substitution in when I write this up in case you can't find the mascarpone cheese or don't want to use it. But I have 8 ounces of it here, and that's all I have in this bowl. So I'm going to add some sugar. I need 1/4 cup of sugar. And then you may notice that on down here on the counter, I have already used my mixer, to mix or to beat some cream. This is whipping cream, and each one of these is 8 ounces. And it takes 8 ounces for a cup, and I need 2 cups worth before it's beaten. So I've emptied both of those cartons. 2 8-ounce cartons were emptied out in here. Then I used my mixer to beat until stiff. And there's no need to wash that mixer before you go on, but you need to come over here and mix your cheese and sugar. So I'll go away and get this done, and also be able to clean up the counter a little bit, and then we'll continue. This is what our mixture of mascarpone cheese and sugar looks like after it's light and fluffy. And what I'm going to do is get some vanilla ready here, and we'll be bringing the whipped cream over to the other bowl. So I'm going to put my vanilla 1 teaspoon in right here, and then we'll bring over the whipped cream. That's all it is. There's nothing added to it, but this is going to make a delicious mixture. And what we want to do is use a large spoon like this and fold the whipped cream into the mascarpone mix. And we'll get that vanilla incorporated as well. And you do want to let that cheese sit out for a bit, so it will be light and fluffy when you take your mixer and mix it. And you can see how easy it is to combine it with the whipped cream. And this is looking luscious. Actually, it will taste good on its own, but when you put the fruit on top of it, it makes it very showy, very appealing. And if you use the chocolate crust, that makes it interesting too. Although you can use just regular pastry crust, that will be fine. And I think that just about have it. You don't want to mash the whipped cream. You want to give it a folding motion, but it is important to get the mascarpone mixture completely blended throughout instead of having a big streak of it like that at the bottom. Try to get that blended in. And that will give you your best pie filling. So here we come over to our crust, and we'll see how far this goes. I have to leave some room for fruit that goes on the top. Just kind of like a cheesecake. Generally, you don't have any limits there, but I'm going to have a little bit of a limit here as to how much I can put in, since this is a small crust. So if you're making this for company, probably you'll want to make a homemade crust, or make sure you get one of those refrigerated crusts that is large enough so you can get all of your pie filling in one pie. This looks like it would almost make two of this size, particularly with me leaving a little room on the top for berries and actually you can choose any fruits that you want. We'll talk more about that when we get ready to mix up our fruits. But the thing that happens next on this recipe is that I'll cover this with plastic wrap and then I will put it in the refrigerator, and it needs to chill for about 8 hours. So after that, we'll be working on our fruit and have it ready to go right on top of this, and it's going to make a beautiful pie. So you'll see that in a minute. We have chilled our cheese pie until it's very cold, and it's workable at this point. And take our plastic wrap off. And this is the pie itself. I kind of regret using that ready-made crust because it doesn't really show you the full beauty of this pie, because it actually was intended to have all of this filling. However, you do get a bonus of two little pies that are crustless, and some people might like that. What we're going to do is make a topping to put on, and it's going to be a fruit topping. Since this is summer, we're using summer fruits. So I've chosen strawberries and blackberries and raspberries and blueberries. You need 4 cups for this size of pie. And of course I would spread it out among my different pies. But I have more strawberries than anything here. So we'll start with strawberries, and I'll just keep an eye on the 4 cup mark on this, but you don't have to put any particular amount of any one fruit. So I'll probably just mix it up a little bit as I go along, and we'll see how it comes out. Excuse me. If we need more of something, then we'll go back and get it. But aren't those pretty together? And where I am at this point is 4 is right here, so I'm not quite up to the 4. I'll just drop a few from each one of these bowls in there. And again, don't worry about the proportions. They don't have to be perfect at all. This should be plenty. Now, to get these sealed together a little bit, what we're going to do is use some strawberry preserves, and this happens to be the sugar-free variety. And for those people that have the crustless pies, that's nice, because that's going to give them less calories without the crust. And then I have orange extract. So I'm putting the orange extract 1 teaspoon in, and it's just a little bottle like that. If you can't find it, you can use about 1/4 cup of orange juice with some orange peel in it. So I'm adding my strawberry preserves, and we're just going to mix this around until it's blended. It doesn't take much. That orange extract just kind of liquefies this a little bit. And now we'll come to our 4 cups of fruit and arrange it however you like on top of your pie. And actually, this is a beautiful pie. Again, I feel like you will do it the best justice if you will make a homemade pie crust. And failing that, at least a larger pie crust than what I have here. It's just that once I got started, I felt like there was no turning back, and I kept going with this. And it looks like I might be able to fit most of the fruit on this one, and I won't bother to show you the others. We'll just concentrate on getting one done, and you would know what to do with the others. Anyway, pack that on as tightly as you want it. If there's a place like that, you might want to clean that up. Once you get your fruit arranged, then you can put your topping over the top of your cheese pie. And I'm just going to take a minute here to try to get this arranged, because it's going to try to stick to the spoon. The fruits are going to try to stick to the spoon a little bit, and I want this to be a thin layer, just kind of a glaze going over the top. So give me a minute. I'll be right back. And here is our cheese pie with summer fruit topping. I hope you enjoy it. I want to show you the piece of pie I have over here, and I'm getting ready to take a bite of it. And since I'm showing, I want to show you the two little pies that were left over. They're good serving sizes. I would say one of these would do both Rick and me. So we'll be saving those for a while. We'll just have to keep them very cold and fresh and eat them before too long. We'll probably give away a lot of the pie and some of the other stuff. But anyway, I want to show you what digging into this pie is like. It's very creamy. I want to show you in the middle here what it would be like if you cut down through there. And taking a bite, I'm going to get some of that crust, that chocolate crust, and some of the fruit on top, and that pie filling. Mmm. This is my kind of dessert. It's sweet, it's tart a little bit. I don't feel guilty eating it because it's got a lot of fruits. And the whipping cream that we used was 36% fat, so it wasn't 100% whipping cream. And I always cut down, like with the low sugar preserves, when I can. And I think this is going to be a really good treat around here for us in the next few days. I hope you enjoy it.